Shalom, friends and colleagues in the USA, Israel, and around the world. And of course, shalom to Dr. Ruth Westheimer and her family. It has become cliche to say that we have learned new ways of interacting. While we would have all rather be celebrating together, in person, in the Sonnenfeld Auditorium, in the Marcus Family Campus, I am so proud of this remarkable first virtual honorary doctorate ceremony. And I want to thank the many people involved in arranging it. I am confident that next year, we can celebrate together at the 2022 Board of Governors meeting at Ben-Gurion University of the Negev. The honorary doctorate is the highest academic honor that our university bestows. We award honorary degrees to persons who have distinguished themselves by academic or creative excellence, or through activities of notable benefit to society and humanity as a whole. We bestow the doctorate honoris causa upon individuals who exemplify the characteristics that we wish to hold up as inspiration to our students and as role models of our own community of scientists, scholars, and supporters. Dr. Ruth Westheimer clearly represents all these values and more. Courage to survive as a child of the Holocaust, to fight for the founding of Israel, to build new lives in new countries, and courage to break accepted codes of what is to be discussed in public. Persistence to continue despite resistance. Creativity to create culture, dialogue, books, and shows. Dr. Ruth, your commitment to taking sexuality out of the clinic and into the living room bettered the lives of millions. By accepting an honorary degree from BGU, you provide us a mirror through which we hope to see a bit of ourselves and honor our institution for what it stands for. Indeed, our university's success is tied to its commitment to instilling values in its students and in the academic products that result from years of persistence and of commitment to excellence. Our ability to impact Be'er Sheva and the Negev, to impact Israel, and to impact the world derives first and foremost from our commitment to academic excellence. Similarly, Dr. Ruth's remarkable influence derives from her strong academic work. Dr. Ruth used her impressive academic training from the University of Paris, the New School, and Columbia University, and her reputation derived from her appointments at New York Presbyterian Hospital, Lehman College, Brooklyn College, Idelphi University, Columbia University, and even West Point, to build the reputation which allowed her to be listened to. And we all listen to this tiny woman with a huge heart and even larger desire to change the world. Dr. Ruth, thank you for helping us raise funds for the Dr. Ruth Westheimer Scholarship in Psychology, which will be awarded annually to two outstanding students. In this way, your name will be tied to BGU forever. I am looking forward to your next trip to Israel so that you can bestow these scholarships in person. In closing, I wonder what David Ben-Gurion would have to say about us honoring you. I know that you have your own theories about Ben-Gurion's private life, so I'll leave us all with a quote from Ben-Gurion's grandson, Dr. Yariv Ben-Eliezer. In response to rumors of certain amorous activities of young people around his grandparents' grave, he responded enthusiastically, "If the information is correct, it makes me very happy that my grandfather, years after his death, serves as an inspiration to young people." You, Dr. Ruth, continue to inspire millions with your remarkable life's work. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, honored guests, welcome to this virtual ceremony conferring an honorary doctorate on Ruth Westheimer, or Dr. Ruth, as she is more commonly referred to, probably the only person capable of using a citation from Pirkei Avot, Ethics of the Fathers, as a dedication for her best-selling book, Sex for Dummies, and Getting Away with It. We will now proceed with the conferring of the honorary doctoral degree. The university honors Dr. Ruth Westheimer and confers upon her an honorary doctorate.
I heard Ben-Gurion declare the state of Israel to be a state. I was in Jerusalem. He talked on the radio in Tel Aviv, and we danced the entire night. In 1939, I was sent with a group of children on a Kindertransport to Switzerland, hoping the parents could leave Germany, which did not happen. And all of us, 50 of us, became orphans of the Holocaust while in Switzerland. Now, I then went to Palestine before it was Israel. I lived in Israel for 6 years. I fought in the Haganah in the War of Independence in 1948. I was very badly wounded, both legs. That's not why I'm short. I would have been short anyway. I believe that it's easy for me to talk about issues of sexuality, because in the Jewish tradition, sex has never been considered a sin. It is very important to keep the art of conversation alive. We are losing that because everybody is on their iPhone all the time. So I did the fourth edition of Sex for Dummies, and I write there how important it is to know, to make time for sex, not to just leave it in the evening and then not have time enough to satisfy your partner. Make sure that you keep time and effort alive in terms of being in a good relationship. I have spent time in Be'er Sheva because I did a film, a documentary about the Bedouins, specifically the Bedouin women and the problems that they have. And this is a delight for me that now I have a book on the Bedouin women and I have a film on the Bedouin women, and now I'm getting an honorary doctorate from Ben Gurion University in the same city, in Be'er Sheva, and I'm establishing a scholarship so that more students will be able to study. And I decided that the scholarship is going to be a scholarship in psychology, and it will be a scholarship in perpetuity, forever. And who knows, maybe a Bedouin woman might apply and might win it. The moment I heard I'm getting an honorary degree at Ben Gurion University in the Negev, I thought, if only Ben Gurion would be alive, I would be so happy, because he was short and he was brilliant.
The Senate and the Executive Committee of Ben-Gurion University of the Negev hereby resolve to honor Dr. Ruth Vestheimer in recognition of a trailblazing researcher and therapist who advanced the field of human sexuality and revolutionized its public discussion, with admiration for her unique and bold media persona as the authority on sex education, advancing the popular understanding of sexuality through groundbreaking radio and television shows, and winning the hearts of her audiences with her unflagging enthusiasm. With respect for an erudite scholar, author of dozens of books, who has given generously of her time and energy to public speaking and educating the next generation of students and researchers. In tribute to a true friend of the State of Israel, who lost her entire family in the Holocaust, Made Aliyah fought fearlessly for the survival of the fledgling state and was severely injured in the War of Independence. With heartfelt appreciation for her generous support of psychology students at Ben-Gurion University of the Negev, and with sincere gratitude for speaking publicly, freely, and openly about private, often hidden matters that are nonetheless the bedrock of our existence, and for decades of singular activity that has profoundly affected the lives of people across the globe, by conferring upon her the degree of Doctor Philosophiae Honoris Causa, with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto.
Here it is.
Okay.
I would like to thank you for joining us today and look forward to seeing you all in person, together with Dr. Ruth, here at Ben-Gurion University of the Negev in next year's honorary doctorate ceremony.